Welcome to Mint. I'm Neha Sethi. In today's edition of From the Newsroom, we are joined by Ramya Nair. Welcome to the show, Ramya.
Thank you.
We are here to talk about India's inflation rate, which has risen to 7.81% in September, which is a 10-month high. So, Ramya, what do you think has led to this acceleration?
The main reason for this increase is basically the diesel price hike that the government did last month. So, in the middle of September, the government increased diesel prices by rupees 5. So, this has now started reflecting in the inflation figures. Food prices have also continued to remain high, though they are lower than what was the increase last month.
So, Ramya, what impact do you think will it have on the RBI's monetary policy?
So, the RBI was expected to cut rates in the October 30th policy, basically because of the figures that came in last week. So, last week, the Index of Industrial Production was released, which showed that India's factory output had risen marginally, showing some kind of recovery in manufacturing activity. Right. Also, the retail inflation figures had also come off. So, there was this hope that, you know, RBI will cut rates. But now, with the inflation numbers coming in at this level, it does look unlikely that, you know, the RBI will cut rates.
Right. Don't you think the Reserve Bank will also factor in the reforms introduced by the government recently?
Reserve Bank has been asking the government to get into fiscal consolidation mode. And the recent measures announced by the government, be it the diesel price increase by rupees 5 or capping the number of LPG cylinders to 6 a year, does indicate the government's move to fiscal consolidation. But given that inflation number is at 7.81%, much above RBI's comfort level of 5%, it does seem unlikely that RBI will focus on growth rather than inflation.
So it looks unlikely that the RBI will reduce rates to help growth. Thank you for joining us, Ramya.
Thank you.
That's all for today. Thank you for watching.